In Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 17, Ephesians 5, 17 says, "Wherefore, be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. And be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit." So he's making a comparison between the natural and the spiritual. In the natural, the person that drinks too much wine or alcohol gets drunk. Well, in the spirit realm, you can do that. Your spirit can be filled, overflowing. And in the Greek, when it says be filled, it's saying actually be filled and stay in that process. There's a little bit of a play on the word. It's be being filled. Have a continual infilling. Well, the person in the natural that's going to get drunk on wine, if he wants to stay drunk, he's got to keep drinking. If you stop drinking, you'll sober up. In the spirit realm, if you're going to stay drunk on the things of God, you've got to keep, and it says the next verse what to do, speaking. You've got to keep speaking. If you get drunk on wine and stay drunk, you have to keep drinking. To stay filled with the Spirit, you have to keep speaking. Be being filled or continually stay full. If you're going to continually stay full, you've got to keep drinking. If you're going to continually stay full of the Spirit, you have to keep speaking. So be being filled by speaking. It doesn't say speak. We're so glad that you were filled with the Spirit and you spoke with other tongues as the Spirit gave utterance. Well, this is saying continually stay full, continually speak. It's not past tense you spoke. It's a continuation of your continuing to speak. Well, I want to stay filled with the things of God. Then you've got to keep doing the things you did that got you filled to begin with. Keep doing that. Well, the devil knows that, so he'll try to pull you away. And sometimes this pressure of circumstances. He can't touch your spirit, but he can apply pressure in your atmosphere, in circumstances. He sometimes can influence other people that are around you. He sometimes can bring an attack in the physical realm. And one reason that he does that is to get you grumbling and complaining and get into doubt and unbelief, where you're no longer speaking the things of God, the word of God, the praise of God, the thanksgiving of God, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. I don't see anything in there that mentions grumbling and complaining and worrying and fearing and doubting and just, it's all going bad. I don't see that in here. Well, look at the circumstances. Look at how bad it is. I don't see that in here. I see if you're going to continually stay filled with the Spirit, you have to discipline yourself to speak in psalms, hymns, spiritual songs, singing, and making melody in your heart to the Lord. I'm going to keep speaking praise and thanksgiving to God. And then as I do, the Spirit of God prompts me. It may be in line with one of the 150 psalms, but it might be new words. Those were inspired by the Spirit of God. Well, I have the Spirit of God. It might be new words. The wonderful hymns that we have that are inspired by God and people wrote them down as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. Well, I might get a new hymn because on the inside I have the Holy Spirit. And I'm singing and making melody in my heart to the Lord. Well, that's how I stay filled, is in the midst of circumstances, whatever pressure comes, I'm just going to speak and sing and praise and give glory to the Lord. Singing and making melody in my heart to the Lord. Speaking to yourselves. Keep speaking. Stay full. Keep drinking in the things of God. Speak the word of God to yourself. Speak the praise of God out loud. Sing and make melody in your heart to the Lord. And then it's not a period. Verse 19 doesn't have a period. It continues giving thanks. Always for all things unto God. Another scripture says, in everything give thanks. So whatever situation I'm in, I can give God thanks. I can thank God for the things he's done. And whatever the devil does, well, in that, I can thank God. I can thank God for the things that are unto God. Jesus said, render unto Caesar the things that are Caesar's. Render unto God the things that are God's. When God does it, I can thank God for it. If the devil does it, I can thank God in it. In everything, give thanks. Well, whatever happens then, I'm thankful. Somebody said, look what happened. Well, thank God. Well, Brother Tony, look what's happening. Well, thank God. Well, this is what happened to me today. Well, thank God. Are you thanking God for it? I'm thanking God in it. If the devil did it, I'm thanking God in it. If God did it, I'm thanking God for it. But either way, I'm thankful. I'm going to be thankful. Well, giving thanks, as you continue to do that, you stay filled with the Spirit. I'm going to maintain the things of God because I'm going to sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, sing and make melody in my heart to the Lord. I'm going to give thanks unto God, always for all things unto God and the Father. How am I going to do it? In the name of the Lord Jesus. Lord, I just praise you. Father, I praise you in the name of Jesus. Lord, I just praise you and thank you for your goodness. Well, there's not a period yet. Submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Just yield. Just be clothed with humility. Just see other people and just, I desire the things of God to be in their hearts and their lives, and that just we just flow together and work together and function as the body of Christ. And every joint has something to supply. I appreciate what the joints are supplying. We need one another, and I'm just going to yield and be in harmony with the body of Christ. If the devil is coming to subvert and pervert, then I resist him, submit to God, resist him in the name of Jesus. But even the enemy, the Lord Jesus said, pray for your enemy. I just want to have this attitude of gratitude and desire to see the things of God in my life and everyone else's life. I'm just going to have the attitude where I'm just going to flow in harmony as much as possible, live peaceably with all men. Well, that's a part of the Spirit-filled life because it's the nature of Jesus Christ. Can somebody say amen? Well, maintain the anointing. There's an anointing of God that's been put into the hearts of the children of God, but we're to maintain that. Maintain the anointing. Well, how do you do that? This is telling you how to do it. Don't be drunk with wine wherein is excess, but I do want you to get drunk. But when I want to make it clear, I'm not talking about natural wine. I want you to be drunk, Paul's saying. This is the will of the Lord. You need to understand what the will of the Lord is. What is the will of the Lord? For you to be drunk. But don't misunderstand. Not the natural wine with the excess of that. I'm talking about get drunk on God and stay that way. Get drunk on God and stay that way. Well, how do you stay that way? Well, the way you get drunk is by drinking. The way you stay drunk is keep drinking. The way that you are filled with the Spirit is speaking. The way you stay full is speaking. Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Sing and make melody in your heart to the Lord. And give thanks always for all things. Whatever happens in your life, just have the attitude of gratitude. I'm going to be thankful. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I know the devil, the Bible tells me to cast out devils, to resist the devil, submit God, resist the devil. Peter said, whom resist steadfast in the faith. I know there's an adversary, there's an enemy. He's walking round about seeking whom he may devour. He's looking to see who he can devour. I know that. And I'm to resist him steadfast in the faith. But how can I do that? Well, I do it with the name of Jesus, and I'm thankful for the name. I'm thankful for the word. I'm thankful for the glory. I'm thankful for the power. I'm thankful for the anointing. I'm thankful that whatever I bind is bound in heaven. I'm thankful for heaven. I'm thankful for whatever I loose on earth is loosed in heaven. I'm thankful for heaven. I'm thankful that when I use the name of Jesus, heaven backs it. I'm thankful for heaven. I'm thankful for the protection. I'm thankful for the provision. I'm thankful for the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm thankful that when Jesus resisted the devil in Matthew 4 and Luke 4, he said, "It is written." He quoted the Bible. I'm thankful I can quote the Bible. I'm thankful I have the sword of the Spirit. I'm thankful I have the shield of faith. I'm thankful that I have the whole armor of God. I'm thankful. And so I see the devil flee before my face in the name of Jesus. He comes against me one way. He flees before me seven ways. I'm thankful that the name of Jesus has the power to cause him to move and to bow and I can resist. I'm thankful. I'm telling you this morning, I'm thankful. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. I'm thankful that I can speak the word and hold fast to the profession of my faith without wavering. I'm thankful that I can cast not away my confidence because it has great recompense of reward. I'm thankful that I can let patience have her perfect work. And when I'm perfect and entire, I don't want anything because I don't have it. I'm thankful that his word produces results. I'm thankful that he watches over his word. He hastens his word to perform it. I'm thankful for the word of God this morning. I'm thankful for the Spirit of God this morning. I'm thankful for the things of God this morning. And I praise the name of the Lord. I give thanks and praise and glory unto the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Maintain the anointing in the midst of circumstances that are contrary to the word. Maintain the anointing. The anointing destroys the yoke. Without the anointing, there's no destroying of the yoke. The anointing, the yoke is destroyed by the anointing. Maintain that anointing. That's how you get the yoke destroyed, is the anointing. Maintain that anointing. Maintain it by speaking. What am I speaking? Praise and thanksgiving. What am I doing it? All the time. How do I maintain that anointing? By speaking. How often do I do it? All the time. How do you maintain the anointing? By speaking. How often should I do that? All the time. In any situation. Whatever comes. It doesn't matter if it's good or bad. Just, I'm going to praise the Lord. I'm going to bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. How often? Continually. What are you going to do? I'm going to bless the Lord. How often? Continually his praise is going to be in my mouth. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. In the good times, in the evil day, I'm going to thank God for his word, for his spirit, for his protection, for his promise, for his provision. I'm thanking God that he is with me. He is for me. He is in me. And the armor of God has been clothed upon me. And I can submit to God and even resist the devil and watch him flee from me. And I give God thanks. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord hastens his word to perform it. His word produces results in my heart, in my life. I see the word of God being performed in my midst. And I give God praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Maintain the anointing. There's a healing anointing that God has put in the church. We lay hands upon the sick and they recover. There is a healing anointing that goes into people as they believe. The woman that had the issue of blood touched Jesus, his clothes, and there's virtue or power or the anointing that left the Lord Jesus and went into that woman. Well, that anointing goes into people. That anointing is also to be maintained. Sometimes we look for things to be instant, and sometimes they are. I think about two people that came to Kenneth E. Hagin. They both had the same diagnosis. They both were in the last stages of the same type of cancer. A man and a woman. He laid hands on the man. The power of God went into him. He fell under the power. And then he comes to this woman. And as he's coming to her and just about to lay his hand upon her And as he does lay his hand upon her, she says out loud, and everyone around her heard her. She said right out loud, "This is it." And he laid hands upon her, and she fell under the power of that anointing. Well, after the service, he checked up. He knew something, he was familiar with them. And so he checked up later to ask some questions because he knew them. And the man, neither of them had any instant manifestation that you could see where there's an outward change. But see, healing is on the inside first. I mean, God can do things in the physical realm, but healing that's believed by faith according to the Word and the Spirit comes on the inside. You think about Jesus. He himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. That sickness and disease was put upon him, and with his stripes, we were healed. Well, he wasn't made sick physically. That healing was produced, and the sickness that he bore was a spiritual work. We receive it spiritually. God can do things in the physical realm, but faith is of the heart. Paul, writing to the Romans in chapter 10, he said, "For with the heart men believeth." If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you confess what you believe. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, I think it's around verse 13, it says, "They believed and spoke, we also believe and therefore speak." We have in the same spirit of faith. 2 Corinthians 4:13. We have the same spirit of faith, or the nature of faith. How faith works is by believing and speaking. And Romans 10, you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and you believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, and you're saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You believe in your heart. You speak with your mouth. Well, healing comes the same way. God can do things in the physical realm. But Jesus himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. Well, he wasn't sick physically. When by whose stripes ye were healed, when he's receiving bringing forth our redemption, he didn't have cancer. He didn't have tuberculosis. He didn't go deaf so we could receive our hearing. He didn't go blind so we could receive our seeing. This is a spiritual work. And it says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, he became sin. But he knew no sin. So he never did sin. Then how did he become sin? It was in the spiritual realm. Well, he didn't know sickness, but he became sick. He didn't sin, but he became sin. He bore our sin. He bore our sickness. I tell you, if you can be cleansed from sin, you can be healed of sickness because Jesus bore it. But it's a spiritual work, and it's received by faith, which is a spiritual work. So these two people, neither of them had any physical manifestation of healing. Now, God can do that, and sometimes healings are instant. But when they're not instant, they can still be believed on the inside. When healings are not physically instant, they still can be believed on the inside and then produce results on the outside. Now, salvation is instant. When you're born again, that's instant. But it's a spiritual work, and your spirit is born again. It's a spiritual work working on the spirit. Is that right? Amen. When you're born again, that's a spiritual work, and it's instant. But healing sometimes is progressive because it's a spiritual work that manifests in the flesh. But it has to be on the inside first. Well, you can lose it. If you start doubting and have wavering and unbelief, you can lose it. Even though it started on the inside, it doesn't continue to produce results on the outside. James said, "Let not that man that wavereth think he'll receive anything." So that's where I need to watch out and guard. That's why I need to stay filled with the Spirit and not have any room for any doubt or unbelief. Well, how do you do that? Well, Paul said in 2 Corinthians chapter 10 that there are strongholds that we're to pull down. And those aren't demons out there somewhere way in the distance. This is talking about faults. It says so in the next verses, pulling down strongholds. But then it says in the next verse, casting down imaginations. Those imaginations are in your mind, images that come to your mind. It goes on in that verse, bringing every thought into captivity. So when thoughts of doubt and unbelief and images in your mind where you see defeat, you see failure, and the devil will present those things to you. You have to pull those down. You have to cast those down. You have to bring those thoughts into captivity and then speak praise and thanksgiving. If you're going to stay filled with the Spirit of God, you've got to resist the doubt. You've got to get that out. It's better not to even let it in. Amen. And then speak things that are consistent with praise and thanksgiving, psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, and giving thanks always for all things unto God and our Father in the name of the Lord Jesus. Well, that's what you do in every situation. It just does not matter. I'm going to bless the Lord at all times. So these two people, they did not have any instant manifestation. Nothing outwardly changed. And yet both of them fell under the power of God. The anointing went into both of them. Well, the man, he was led out and helped in the car. And some of the people that brought him to the service asked him, as he's been helped into the car after the service, "Well, did you get anything with Brother when Brother Hagin laid his hands upon you?" And he said out loud, they heard him. He said out loud in response to their question, "I didn't get anything. I didn't expect to get anything." Well, it wasn't too much longer than that the cancer continued and finished its work, and he died. But his answer, the healing anointing went into him, but he didn't see what people do is they go looking. How do I feel? What do I see? And he said, "I didn't get anything. I didn't expect to get anything." Now, the lady, her husband took her home, carried her up to the bed, upstairs to the bed. The next morning, she said she wanted to come downstairs for breakfast. He fixed breakfast. He carried her down the steps into the breakfast area. I think they had a breakfast nook in the kitchen. So they're there in the kitchen. And before they had breakfast, they prayed over the breakfast, but they also prayed thanking God for her healing. See, there's no physical manifestation. She's just as weak. She just looks as sick, feels just as weak and sick as she did before. But she said, "This is it. This is it. This is the point where I began believing the anointing comes in me to do a work." And that anointing is there to effect a healing and a cure and to drive out that which Satan has wrought. And she said, "This is it." And yet she didn't feel anything physically, didn't look any different physically, just as weak, just as sick. And so they were praising and thanking God for the healing anointing. Lord, thank you for the healing anointing. Thank you for the healing anointing. Thank you that healing anointing is in me. And he would pray in her, and she's agreeing, in me, doing a work, effecting a healing and a cure. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your word, for your spirit, and for the anointing. And we just praise you for it. Well, they have breakfast, and he carries her back upstairs. The next morning, they do the same thing. The next morning, they do the same thing. The next morning, they do the same thing. It was 10 days before they saw any physical results. It was 10 days before they saw any change in the physical. And then she lived. She didn't die with that cancer. She lived with the healing. But she maintained the anointing with faith, believing, praise, and thanksgiving. She maintained the anointing even when it didn't look like anything was working. But she proclaimed, "This is it." And it was it too. That was it. I've got it, and I'm not going to let my physical talk me out of it. I've got it, and I'm not going to let how I feel t- talk me out of it. I've got it, and I'm not going to let how what I see talk me out of it. I've got it. This is it. And I'm thanking God for it. Thanking God for it. Thanking God for it. Hallelujah. And she lived. The man died. She lived. But it was 10 days before there was any physical change in her body at all. This is it. Maintain the anointing. Maintain the faith of His Word, the faith of His Spirit, the faith of the anointing. Maintain your believing with praise and thanksgiving. Maintain your believing by speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and our Father in the name of the Lord Jesus. Maintain the fullness of the Spirit. Maintain the anointing. Can somebody say amen? Maintain the anointing. Maintain the faith. Maintain the believing without wavering. Why? Well, Hebrews 10:23 says, hold fast to the profession of your faith without wavering. Now, why? He's faithful. He's faithful. He's faithful. Yeah, but I don't see anything. That's why you have to maintain it. But I don't see it. That's why you have to maintain it. That's why you have to hold fast, because circumstances will come and try to rob you of what God has provided and promised and through His Word and by His Spirit and the anointing has given. The circumstances will try to rob you. You have to hold fast to the profession of your faith without wavering. Why? He's faithful. He promised it. He provided it. He's faithful. And He'll do it. He'll do it. In fact, in some realms, in these realms, these are things He's already done. By whose stripes ye were healed. So maintain it. Hold fast to the profession of your faith without wavering. For He is faithful who promised. Well, blessed be God. He's promised it. He's provided it. It's in His Word. And this is it. I have the believing of it. I've believed and I speak. I believe and I speak. I have believed and I speak. I do believe and I speak. And this is it. I've got it. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. Say it out loud. This is it. I've got it. Turn and tell your neighbor, I've got it. Amen. Amen. That's a good word of encouragement. In every situation, without hesitation, give God the praise and adoration, and don't be slow about it. We had that word come several months ago. It might be a couple of years ago by now. But we had that word come by the Spirit of God. In every situation, without hesitation, give God the praise and adoration, and don't be slow about it. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. In every situation, without hesitation, give God the praise and adoration, and don't be slow about it. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. So in any situation, in every situation, whatever comes, makes no difference. I'm going to give thanks always for all things unto God. And it says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, is that where it is? In everything give thanks. Did you put that up? She's so good to look some things up. I think that's 1 Thessalonians 5. Verse 18. In everything give thanks. Well, that pretty much covers it, doesn't it? That pretty much covers it, doesn't it? In everything, give thanks. for this is the will of God. Well, we need to understand what the will of the Lord is. We just read in Ephesians. So this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. What's the will of God? Well, here the will of God is giving thanks in everything. How often do people come to me sometimes to grumble and complain? And I don't always say it out loud. But I'm thinking, very often I'm thinking, well, thank God. Because in everything give thanks. Can somebody say amen? Years ago, I bought a piece of real estate. It was a mobile home. I was going to use it as a rental property. The neighbors learned about that, and they didn't want just anybody living beside them. They liked the neighbors they had, but then I came along and bought it, and they found out I was going to use it as a rental property, and just anybody then, you know, the riffraff might come in. Now, we couldn't prove it, but they set fire to the place. So they were never prosecuted because we couldn't prove it, but we knew who it was. We knew who did it. I got a phone call. Your mobile home down such and such that I just bought, hadn't moved anybody in. I had rented it, but they hadn't moved in. Thank God for that. But I got a phone call. This is years ago. And on the phone, they said, your mobile home that you have down on such and such a road was burned to the ground last night. First thing out of my mouth was, well, praise the Lord. Amen. That's the first thing I said. Well, praise the Lord. That's the first thing I said. And this is 30, 40 years ago. The first thing I said on the phone, I'm answering the phone. I don't know what is. Well, actually, I got a message to call back. So I'm calling the person back, calling back. All right, I'm returning the phone call. This is, you know, hello. The mobile home that you bought. Mobile home that you had down on such and such a highway burned to the ground last night. And the first thing out of my mouth was, well, praise the Lord. I tell you, you'll have victory if you'll have that attitude. You'll have victory if you'll have that attitude. Amen. Amen. The flesh doesn't want to do it. That's where you have to cast down imaginations and bring thoughts captive and discipline the flesh. I'm going to bless the Lord at all times, not just the good times, but at all times. I'm going to bless the Lord at all times, not just the good times, but all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. What am I doing? I'm maintaining the anointing. I'm maintaining the provision, the power, the promise, what He has purchased for me by His own precious blood. I'm a child of God. God is my Father, and I'm going to give Him praise and thanksgiving. I'm more than a conqueror in Him. Not in me, in Him. In Him. Look what the Lord has done for me. I'm going to praise Him. And I'm going to walk in victory. Because He came to purchase that and provide that. He desires that. I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your souls prosper. The victory that overcomes the world is my faith. My faith is in God. My faith is by the word of God. My faith is released by the words that I speak. I believed and I speak. And my speaking is mixed with praise and thanksgiving. In every situation, without hesitation, give God the praise and adoration. And don't be slow about it. And you'll see the victory. Can somebody say amen?